हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सिंपल पास्ट टेंस. बट बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग आई वांट टू डिस्कस फ्यू थिंग्स विथ यू ऑल. चिल्ड्रेन, डू यू रिमेंबर व्हेन यू वर इन क्लास 1 or 2, द मेमोरीज, द बेस्ट मेमोरीज ऑफ योर लाइफ, लाइक हाउ यू सेलिब्रेटेड योर बर्थडे, हाउ द टीचर प्रेज्ड यू इन फ्रंट ऑफ ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ यू वेंट टू द मार्केट विथ योर पेरेंट्स फॉर शॉपिंग. So many good memories are there and some bad memories also. Okay, like the harsh moments you fought with your friend, the teacher scolded you in front of your friends, your mother gave a slap to you because you were not listening to her. Maybe there can be so many examples, the good memories, bad memories we had in our past. So children, can we change our past? No. We cannot, because the things, there are many things which had already happened. We can only remember those moments. We can only think about those moments, but we cannot change it. In the same way, children, do you know about your future? No, we don't know. We have not seen our future. See children, what is the difference between past and future? We have seen the past, but we cannot change it. In the same way, we have not seen our future, but we can change it. How? By working hard in our present. So, present is very important, children. Work hard, give your best, whatever you want to do, you can fulfill your dreams now, so that you can have a bright future. So, it's very simple, children. We cannot change our past, but we know what was there. We have not seen our future, but it is in our hand to change it, to make it bright. Okay, how? By working hard in our present. So, here in our last video, I have explained you simple present tense. Today, we are going to do simple past tense. Can you see here? Few examples are written. Like yesterday, whatever you did yesterday, you all remember. And maybe you have planning for the next day. That is in the future, for tomorrow. Next is last year in 1476. Last year, sorry, it is different. Last year, when you were in class 4. In 1476, many, many years before. In 1995, 5 years back, last week. So all these are in past tense, the things which have happened in these years. Let's see what is simple past tense. So, the simple past tense expresses a completed action, means the action which is already completed. We cannot change it, but we can discuss on it. We can remember those things, okay? Or describes a situation in the past, like you had many experience. Suppose teacher had gave you some work and how did you solve it? Like we can also say, when do we use the simple past tense? So, when the event is in the past. Or when the event is completely finished. Let's see how to change. Like from walk, we can write walked, eat, ate, drink, drank, fall, fell, sleep, slept. There can be more examples, children. See here, daily routines which we are going to write in past tense. Okay. Like I woke up, I got up, I took a shower, I got dressed, I combed my hair. I had breakfast, I went to work, I started work, I answered emails, I had lunch, I finished work, I arrived home, I fed the dog, I cooked dinner, I had dinner, I watched TV, I went to bed, I fell asleep. So children, he's a boy, okay, he wrote about his daily routine. But he has written in past tense. Suppose he has written for yesterday. So how will you write for today? Or how will you write in simple present tense? Let's write in simple present tense, children. Like we can write, I wake up at 6 a.m. Or I get up. I take a shower. I get dressed. I comb my hair. I have breakfast. I go to work. I start work. I answer emails. I have lunch. I finish work. I arrive home, I feed the dog, I cook dinner, I have dinner, I watch TV, I go to bed, and last one is I fall asleep. Suppose you have to write for tomorrow. That is future tense. So how will you change it? You have to add will in every sentence. Like, I will wake up, I will get up, I will take a shower, I will get dressed, I will comb my hair, I will have breakfast, I will go to work, I will start work, I will answer emails, I will have lunch, I will finish work, I will arrive home, I will feed the dog, I will cook dinner, I will have dinner, I will watch TV, I will go to bed, and last one is I will fall asleep. So what happened, children? You can take any sentence. Suppose you have taken a sentence in past tense. So try to change in present and future tense so that the topic will be clearer to you. Okay, let's move forward. Now, what are the rules for simple past? See, children, for you, we always write were. You were absent yesterday. And children, it doesn't matter it is singular or plural. You can be used with both singular and plural. And with you, we will always use were only in past tense. Like, suppose we are writing for a single boy. So we will write, you were absent yesterday. Suppose we are writing for five students. So there also we will write the same thing. You were absent yesterday. Or you all were absent yesterday. Okay. Now see, for others, like in singular, when we are talking about he, she, or it, or for any name, for a girl or a boy, then we will write, he was absent yesterday. She was. It was. Ram was. Shyam was. Riya was, John was, like this. And suppose when we are writing in plural, like they were absent yesterday, we were absent yesterday, Rohan and Sohan were absent yesterday, the students were absent yesterday. Okay, so please make it clear, for singular we use was, but with plural we use were. And there is one exceptional case, that is you. It is singular or plural, it doesn't matter, we have to write were all the time. Now see here. Note, even for I, we use was as in singular. See, children, we have learnt in our previous video that with I, we use the plural verb. Like, I have a book. I teach English. So, we are using plural verb. But here, in past tense, for I, we will always use was. Like, in present tense, we always use I am. In the same way, in simple past tense, we will use I was. Okay, now negative sentences examples. They were not laughing at the joker. Just see here, children. They is plural, so we have used were. They were not laughing. He was not taking exam last month. So he is singular, so we have used was. Question number 3. You were. Yes, I have told you, with you, we will always use were only. So, you were not waiting for him yesterday. She was not working in a factory. She is singular, so we have used was. It was. It is also singular, so we have used it was not raining yesterday. Let's see more examples, children. But here, different verbs are there. We have learned the helping verb there, was and were. Now, we will use different verbs. Like, number 1. He met his wife 6 years ago. So, met is the past tense of meet. Suppose we have to write in simple present tense. So, what we will write, children? He meets his wife. Okay. And suppose we have to write in future tense. So, we will write, he will meet his wife. Okay. Now, next. They watched a movie yesterday. So, watched is a past tense of watch. Change into present tense. They watch a movie today. And future tense, they will watch a movie tomorrow. Next one, she didn't study in the library. Children, one thing here is there, that in past tense, whether it is singular or whether it is plural, you have to use did only. Like in present tense, children, I am doing revision also of simple present tense. Okay, please take care of that. Like in simple present tense with singular, we were writing does. So, how we will change here? She does not or doesn't study in the library. And if it is plural, then we will write, they do not study in the library. But in past tense, we always write did. In present tense, we write do for plural and does for singular. But in simple past tense, we always write did, whether it is singular or plural. Please keep this in your mind. Now next, the police didn't find any clues. And one more thing, see children, we are writing the root form of verb with a negative sentence, like they didn't study. The police didn't find. We will not write studied or found. Okay, whether it is a simple present tense or simple past tense, we will write the root form of verb with negative and interrogative sentences. Number 5, I became a teacher 2 years ago. Became is the past tense of become. Number 6, he bought a new car last week. Bought is past tense of buy. Children, many students get confused between bring, brought, buy, bought. Please learn this. We studied very hard last night. And the last one is, I graduated from the university last year. Children, you can do one thing. Take at least 10 verbs and change into simple past tense. Next, negative sentences. It is also very simple, children. See here, it is simpler than simple past tense. Simple present tense. Like in simple present tense, what we were doing? We were using do and does according to singular and plural, noun or pronoun. But here you don't have to take any tension. Why? Because here, whether it is singular or plural, we have to use did only. And it is negative sentences, so we will use did not. And contraction of did not is didn't. So with whether it is I, we, you, they, she, he, it, whatever, singular or plural, noun or pronoun, we will use did only. So let's see the examples. Like Dinah didn't study for her exam. Children, Dinah is a girl. We are talking about singular noun. We have used did. Suppose we are writing for two girls, Dinah and Rhea. There also we will write the same thing. Dinah and Rhea didn't study for their exam. And the verb will go in root form. Let's see a few more examples. I did not want to learn English. Children, see here. We are writing in past tense, but learn we have written in root form. Again, I am telling this. Why? Because in negative and interrogative sentence, we write the root form of verb. We will not write, I did not want to learn English. It is wrong. Yes, past tense of learn is learned, but when we are making negative and interrogative sentences, we will write the root form of verb. I have said so many times, I hope you all have learned it. Next, you didn't listen to music yesterday. He did not play football in Mexico. Children, where you can write either did not or didn't, both are right. We didn't live in a flat 2 years ago. She didn't use the correct word in this exercise. They didn't like Rome. Okay, now how will you change the sentences into interrogative form? Let's see. Now, open question or WH question. We have already learned about WH questions. When, where, what, which. Okay, so first we are writing the question word, then auxiliary for past, then subject and then verb in the simple form. Like, what did you do? Closed question or yes, no question. See children here. Did you go to the cinema? So what we have done? You, we are, with you, we always take plural verb. So we have written here did. Okay, but it is simple past tense. So whether it is singular or plural, it doesn't matter. We have to write did only. Like, did you go to the cinema? And go, we have written in. Go, we have written in. Root form of verb. We will not write went. Okay, because in interrogative sentences, we write the root form of verb. Example. Did you want to learn English? Like we have written here, say children. You is again. With you, we can write did only because there is no plural or singular. Did you listen to music yesterday? Now, third one, here you have to take it. Did he play football in Mexico? See, children, he is singular, but we have written D only. Like, next one, did we live in a flat 2 years ago? Again, see, children, it is plural, then also we have written did. What does it mean? That whether it is singular or plural, we will write did only. Next one, did she use the correct word in this exercise? And the last one is, did they like Rome? So, whether it is singular or plural, we have used did only. So, in simple past tense, we will write did. Next one is interrogative form past simple. Now, affirmative form we have to change into interrogative form. Like, I went to supermarket. So, went is the past tense of go. Like, how will you frame sentence? Did you go to the supermarket? So, went has changed into go. We have to write the root form of verb. Next one, you lived in New York. So, first we will start with did. Did you live? Lived will change into live. Did you live in New York? She played football. Did she play football? Now, we will see all the three types of sentences like positive form, negative form and question form. Let's read it fast. I worked. I didn't work. Did I work? You worked. You didn't work. Did you work? We worked. We didn't work. Did we work? They worked. They didn't work. Did they work? She worked. She didn't work. Did she work? He worked. He didn't work. Did he work? It worked. It didn't work. Did it work? So children, I hope you have well understood this chapter, simple past tense. Just practice all the book exercises. It will be more clearer to you. Thank you, children.